Praise be to Lord Jesus Christ. Good day, children. Hope all are happy to be here in the presence of Jesus. Let's begin today's class with a short prayer. Join your hands and bow your heads in prayer. In the name of the Father and of the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we praise and thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you for guiding us throughout this year. You have blessed us with good parents, teachers, and friends. You have protected us from all difficult situations. You have helped us to overcome all difficult moments with courage and wisdom. Thank you, Lord, for protecting us under your wings. Amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the previous lesson, we have learned about the leaders of Israel. As the Israelites occupied the promised land Canaan, the judges were blessed to lead the people as they were blessed with talents and divine power. Slowly, the people of Israel longed to have a king like other nations. God appointed Saul to be the first king. Slowly, Saul was taken over by King David, the powerful warrior, and David anointed his son Solomon, the wise king. The kings ruled the nation with power and wealth. Israel was blessed with wealth and prosperity during their reign. A great temple was built in Jerusalem. Do you know who built the temple in Jerusalem? Yes, very good. It was Solomon, the wise king. But still, their loyalty to God and his commands reduced. Whenever the people of Israel went away from the Lord, he tried to protect them in different ways. After the kings, God gave the Israelites the prophets. Let's learn about them in this lesson. Prophets were people ordained by God. The common meaning of the word prophet is the one who speaks for God. I repeat, the common meaning of the word prophet is the one who speaks for God. The prophet of Israel pointed out to the people their faults, accused them harshly, and warned them to repent. There are prophets who exerted great influence in the history. The Old Testament contains books named after many of these prophets. The books which are large are Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and Daniel. The Bible also contains very small books named after 12 other prophets. They are Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. The large books are also called as great prophets or major prophets. The small books are called as lesser prophets or minor prophets. Israel also had some great prophets in whose name there are no books. Chief among them are Elijah and Elisha. We read about them in the book of Kings. Israel had several other prophets as well. The disciples of these prophets collected the great proclamation of them and later wrote them down as books. Now let's see about the prophet Elijah. During the period of King Ahab, the king built a temple for God Baal and sacrificed two of his sons. Prophet Elijah warned the king that he would be punished for his idolatry. He advised the king to repent and return to the Lord. Finally, Elijah challenged the prophet of Baal. Their sacrifice was not accepted. But when Elijah offered, God responded. Fire came down from heaven and consumed the sacrifice. Seeing this, the people fell on the ground and said, God indeed is Lord. Now let's watch a small clipping from the story of Elijah, how the prophet of Baal offered a sacrifice and Elijah offered the sacrifice and how God has accepted them and which made the people to believe in the Lord.
Fire, 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 God Baal!
The priests shouted and danced around the altar, yelling to Baal to start the fire. They shouted and shouted from morning to noon with no answer.
Why isn't our God sending the fire?
Is it? Maybe he isn't the true God at all.
Let's see if Elijah's God sends the fire.
Elijah's altar. Finally, Elijah called the people over to his altar. He began to make his altar. He placed the woods, took some stones, and put them around his altar. Then Elijah did something very strange. He asked the people to pour water over his bull and the wood.
Huh? Did he just ask us to pour water over his altar?
Yeah. How will the wood burn if we pour water on them?
He is a fool.
If Baal can't help us, then how can his God send the fire?
People did as Elijah said. They poured water over the woods and the bull. Everything now was soaked in water. After the entire altar was soaked, Elijah stepped forward and simply prayed.
O Lord, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, show us today that you are the real God of Israel and that all I have done is obeyed you. Show your power to these wavering people. Let them see that you are the one true God.
Just as Elijah finished his prayer, fire burst out of the altar and everything was covered in flames. Every single thing was burned down to nothing, and even the water in the trenches were gone.
Huh?
The people watched, completely amazed, and they began to fall on their knees.
The Lord, He's God!
The Lord, He is real God!
Elijah was a prophet who in this way worked to strengthen the faith of the people in the Lord. Now, let's go on with the activity to revise what we have learned in this lesson. Find out the names of great prophets from the given jumbled letters. So we have a set of jumbled letters here. Do you remember the great prophets? Yes. How many of them are there? There are four great prophets. Who are they? try to identify them. Here we have Isaiah. The next person, Jeremiah. And the third person is Ezekiel. And finally, we have Daniel. Very good, children. You have done a great job. Now let's go into the second activity. Here, we are asked to fill in the blanks with the best answers. The words given in the box are Elijah, Elisha, Daniel, Ezekiel, 12, Jeremiah, Isaiah, and prophet. Now let's move on to the question. The common meaning of the word dash is the one who speaks for God. Yes, I'm able to hear you, children. It's the word prophet. The common meaning of the word prophet is the one who speaks for God. The second question. The great prophets are dash, 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 and dash. Yes, now I think all are very familiar with these. They are Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and Daniel. The third question. There are dash small prophets. Do you remember how many small prophets are there? Very good. There are 12 small prophets. Now, going on to the next question, we read about the prophets dash and dash in the book of Kings. So, in the book of Kings, about which prophet are we learning? Very good, children. It's Elijah and Elisha. So, we have revised what we have learned. We have revised what we have learned through these activities. We have known that prophet is a person who speaks for us. We have one more activity for you. You are supposed to memorize the 12 smaller prophets or minor prophets and write them in your catechism classwork. Now let's end the class with a short prayer. Join your hands, close your eyes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, Amen. We thank you and praise you, Lord, for the wonderful moments you have given us, for the time we were able to share together. We thank you and praise you, for you have given us the prophets to lead us. Same way, in today's world, we have our priests, our nuns, and a catechism teacher who has spared their time and hard work to create a new life in us. We thank you for all the gifts you have showered on us and blessed us with. We ask all these in your precious name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, Amen. Thank you, children. Have a great day. Hope to meet you in the next class. Praise be to Lord Jesus Christ.